Wonder brings me to my knees. More accurately, I nearly squash wonder. Earlier this month, I have the good, well, more accurately, the great fortune to be at one of the wonders of the world, Boston Children's Hospital, which is both a sober and inspiring place. One of my kids is having a tough but completely recoverable surgery. During her surgery, I steal down to grab a coffee and have to stutter stop and jerk myself upright so as not to squash a teeny tiny dark-haired confection who has stopped abruptly in my path. This fierce little creature jams up traffic when she suddenly catches notice of the grand dramatic sweep of Children's signature floor-to-ceiling media wall from the Drucker Foundation, projecting 100 feet of stimulating distraction. Casted arms reach up, hands fist into balls, little body rears back, and our hero releases a wordless yawp so loud that anyone who hadn't been watching the wonderful scene unfold is stopped short by the ear-splitting shock of her awe. Little body vibrating, she howls again as a gargantuan grinning gray seal dramatically pixelates into an eye-blazing sunrise melting over a canopy of trees, like she's shouting across the rooftop of the world set ablaze as if for her alone. This is untamed joy embodied. This is the sound of pure wonder. Weary mom, pushing along another jewel-lipped baby, calls for our little hero to come. Hero toddles sideways, uncorking another happy screech at, no joke, an enormous potted plant. Mom, blushing, flicks her eyes to the traffic jam. But the grim pilgrimage, blue gods, stethoscoped angels, and the rest of the inconvenienced gridlock have collectively recognized the sweetness of this wunderkind in the midst of the usual grind of this hard and hopeful place. Now, the yawper has found an orange hazard cone inexplicably screwed to a square dolly on wheels. She tows it. It skitters a little. Ignoring Mom's warning, she kicks it a bit further. Sighing, Mom turns toward the exit. I greet this little darling with encouragement to follow Mom. She cranes her neck all the way up the length of me to catch my eye. I am rewarded with a most delightful and generous grin before she skitters off to follow Mom out the revolving door, fascinated by the new magic of this mechanism. I Samaritan the hazard cone back to its original resting place, and I offer up a prayer for this little one and her family, and then a thought for myself. Return me to wonder on wonder. Wisdom begins in wonder, so said Plato, more or less, quoting Socrates. And wonder is connected to curiosity. Curiosity is what has many times saved me from despair, replacing angst with awe, lifting me out of my reactive brainstem and all the way up to my creative problem-solving brain. And yet, I seem, we all seem, to lose our wonder in the bustle of busy lives, dragged ever forward by deadlines and commitments, dragged outward by constant stimulation. A downside to this miraculous digital evolution we are living into, curiosity, if we let it, takes us inward to contemplation and upward toward wonder and gratitude and joy. The holidays offer every opportunity for wonder and curiosity, and yet, for a variety of reasons, we seem to lose wonder to bustle, obligation, and the overwhelm. My friend, colleague, and mentor, Rhonda, often employs the phrase, I'm curious, and I find myself saying it all the time now. So, let's get curious. Let's life hack our way back to wonder. I am heading into Thanksgiving, threshold to the holidays, with this one emphatic goal in my mind. I have literally written it on a post-it, and I'm driving around with it on my dashboard. Return me to wonder. How do I put on the wonderful eyes of a curious child? Can I get my shopping done early and just be quieter in general? Turn off tech and connect with my family by playing games or cooking together? Why is it so easy and strangely tempting to give into the frenzy of the season, to eat too much, buy too much, drink and party too much, and all to what end? What about a quieter approach to the season? Decide on a word, a phrase, or a mantra, and maybe let this serve as your wonder guide to the season. For me, I'm going to try to find the joy in waiting and being quiet in the waiting. I so want the holidays, these holy days, to be about joy, love, peace, connection, fun, and wonder. I do believe in the goodness of humanity, and I am determined to be a part of that goodness. Small acts of kindness, quiet moments, to give space for wonder to wander back in. As December is fast upon us, may you consciously find a way for your holiday season to be wonderful.